What's up everybody, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you, and today we will discuss on another very fundamental topic in astrology, and that is the concept of Digbala, directional strength. Yes, many of you have been requesting for this video and finally it's out now. Alright, if you are new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up, and if you want a consultation, then please approach me in my website below. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Alright, so if you want me to make any other video, then please let me know in the comments. So today we will discuss on what is known as directional strength in Vedic astrology. Alright, so what are the four directions? We have north, east, west, south. Alright, then this is represented in the horoscope in the Kalpurush Kundli by seeing the first house, fourth house, seventh house and the tenth house. So now the first house represents the direction where the sun rises, because when sun is rising, it is in the first house. Yes, anybody born during sunrise is having sun in the first house. So that is the direction where the sun is at its most powerful state, apart from the fact that it is also the strongest when it's in the 10th house. Now, what does Digbala means? Dig means direction and Bala means strength. So there are particular houses, yes, for every planet where the planet performs extremely well because it is placed in that direction where it can perform its characteristics, or which is known as karak tattvas in astrology, in the best possible way. I'll explain that. So for the planets which are related to fire, which are the planets related to fire? Yes, Agni Tattva. Agni Tattva planets are Sun, Mars and Ketu. So now we don't consider Rahu Ketu here. We are taking only the remaining seven planets. So the planets which are of Agni Tattva, fiery element, they get directional strength in the 10th house, which means whenever you see that somebody has Sun or Mars in the 10th house, that means you have to understand that those two planets are having directional strength. The blessings of the Digpalas are there. Yes, we have different Digpalas. We have Indra, then we have Yamaraj, then we have Kubera, then we also have Varuna. Yes, so the fiery planets get directional strength in the 10th house, like Sun and Mars. Now the question is, why do they get directional strength in the 10th house? Why not in other houses? Because the answer is very simple, because fire represents purpose and 10th house is the house of direction, purpose, goal, aim, objective, ambition. So fire basically is what? Fire is basically the desire to prove something to somebody that I am this, I am that. Yes, that's what is fire. That is why everybody wants to prove to others that I am also somebody in this world. That is why planets like Sun and Mars, which represent all these karak tattvas which I said just now, they get directional strength in the 10th house. Alright, so that means if somebody has Sun or Mars in the 10th house, then we have to understand that whatever Sun and whatever Mars represents, these people will have these traits very strongly in their life, which means they'll be very much focused towards their career, towards their ambition, towards making a stance in life. They will always want to prove themselves to others. They will always want to do things in a way that leaves a mark for the entire lifetime. Also, the areas which Sun and Mars rules in their chart, they will also be extremely strong. So for example, if somebody is a Leo ascendant, and then for Leo ascendant, if Sun is in the 10th house in the sign of Taurus, then we have to understand that now Sun is not Sun, it is also the Lagna Lord. So this becomes even more strong. The Lagna Lord itself is in Digbala. Or if somebody is an Aries or a Scorpio ascendant with Mars in the 10th house, then also the same rule applies, because now the Lagna Lord itself is in directional strength. Yes, so then what happens is the important thing to note here is directional strength only comes in the Kendra, in the angular houses, in the 1st, 4th, 7th and 10th. Because they represent the prominent pillars of the horoscope. Yes, first house is you, your body, your image, your appearance, your thought process. Lagna is intelligence basically. Then fourth house is the house of your home, luxury, comforts, where you are at ease and peace, is the house of your mother. Then seventh house is the house of your spouse, your marriage, your interactions with others, other people basically. And 10th house is the house of your status, name, fame, career, work, prosperity, money. Yes, and that's what is the 10th house. And we can see that when Sun is in the 10th house, that is during the afternoon time when it is very hot in the sky. Everybody notices that, oh, the Sun is shining brightly, unless there are clouds, of course, which is represented by Rahu. So anyways, so the fiery planets get directional strength in the 10th house. Yes, Sun and Mars. So especially I have seen, if somebody has Mars in the 10th house, these people are very headstrong with anything that they want to do in life. If they want to do something in life, they are going to do it irrespective of whatever other people say. Yes, so these are very good placements. So if there is any planet in Digbala, then the direction pulls that planet. Yes, or that planet will pull the person into that direction. So for example, if somebody has Surya in the 10th house, then it is one of the very good indicators that one can be a good politician or a civil servant. Of course, there are thousands and millions of people who have Sun in the 10th house. That does not mean everybody who has Sun or Mars in the 10th house will become a government official or somebody in the army or navy or air force. I'm not saying that, but that is one of the very strong indicators. Yes, because 10th house ultimately shows your status. So when Sun is there, it shows that your status may come from government, depending on other placements, depending on how the Lagna Lord is, where the 10th Lord is sitting. Yes, so if somebody is a Scorpio ascendant with Sun in the 10th house, then this becomes even more strong, because Sun is also the 10th Lord. So when 10th Lord is sitting in the 10th house, this becomes another very strong indicator for somebody who is in the government services. Yes, so that means especially when Sun or Mars is in the 10th house, then these people can become very good leaders. Yes, because 10th house is the house of decision making. 10th house tells you how do you make decisions. Yes, that means when there are fiery planets like Sun or Mars, then it is seen that these people, the kind of decisions which they make, they just don't make it in the air. They will also stick to it, and this is very good for your spiritual pursuits also. So for example, if somebody has Sun in the 10th house and then they decide that, okay, from tomorrow I am going to chant this mantra every day. So once they decide, they are very likely to stick to it. Of course, depending on other situations, depending on how well the Lagna Lord is placed, where is the Lagna Lord placed, how is the overall strength of the chart, how powerful is their moon, or is the prominent planets like Sun, Moon in the axis of Rahu and Ketu, then there can be challenges. Or especially if it is aspected or conjunct with Saturn, then there can be challenges in maintaining our commitments for a long term. But in general, I have seen that if somebody has Sun or Mars in the 10th house, then it becomes very, very, very good for decisions. Because when there are fiery planets in the 10th house of decisions, then it shows that the person sticks to whatever he decides. Yes, he or she. So that means it is very good to have Sun or Mars in the 10th house. So many times people ask me that, okay, now I am going to have this baby, the doctor is telling, okay, when should I when do you want us to cut that the cord from which your baby will come out. So sometimes when they will do this baby planning, etc., alright, so then if somebody asks me, I just simply tell them that just make sure that if other placements are fine, that in Kendra there are some planets which are in Digbala that will be very strong. Yes, that means especially if you can put Sun in the 10th house, it is very good. Or the other planets like Prithvi Tattva, Mercury gets directional strength in the first house. Even the ether element, the planet that signifies ether element, which is Jupiter, that also gets directional strength in the first house. And then the planets which represent emotions like water, happiness, enjoyment, Moon and Venus, they get directional strength in the fourth house. And the planet which is of Vayu Tattva, that is Saturn, which gets directional strength in the seventh house. Alright. So this is how we study the directional strength of the planets, and this is the first video on directional strength of the planets of Agni Tattva, fiery planets. And in the subsequent videos, we will be discussing on the directional strength of the other planets, Moon, Venus, Jupiter, Mercury and Saturn. Alright, so basically Sun and Mars in the 10th house is very good for traits related to Sun and Mars. These people are known as go-getters. They can go and achieve anything in this world, unless Sun is very badly afflicted or it is in a state of debility. Yes. So now there's a question which people ask: what if Sun is in an enemy sign, or it is debilitated, or it is afflicted by other malefics like Saturn, Rahu, Ketu especially, and if it is still in the 10th house? Then what it means is that because Surya is in the 10th house, this person will still have a lot of name, fame and recognition. But if sign wise, because see, whenever Sun is in the 10th house, although it is in the 10th house, it will be sitting in some sign. So what if the sign is not a very great sign? So for example, what if Sun is sitting in a air sign, for example Libra for a Capricorn ascendant, or suppose it is sitting in the sign of Gemini, or it is sitting in the sign of Aquarius. Yes, then these are not very great signs for Sun to sit in, because Sun gets debilitated in a air sign. So then people get this confusion: oh, is this good, is this bad? No, the answer is very simple. There is nothing good or bad. First of all, it depends on the whole chart. But if you talk individually of Sun itself, then we have to understand that when a planet is in directional strength, then that direction will pull the person in those areas. So for example, if Sun is in the 10th, the person can become a great leader. But suppose the sign where Sun is placed, that is not very great. Yes, then what I have observed is, in layman's terms, the person has to put more efforts to get to that position or to maintain that position. Or suppose there is a Cancer ascendant who has Sun in the 10th house, in the sign of Aries. So now here Sun is not only in directional strength, it is also exalted, because Sun gets exalted in Aries, right? Compared to a Capricorn ascendant, because the opposite ascendants, yes, they are opposite ascendants. So for a Capricorn, the sign of Libra is in the 10th house. That means if Sun is in the 10th house for a Capricorn ascendant, being the 8th lord, it is also debilitated. Yes. So then I have seen in my own experience that for a Cancer and for a Capricorn, although if Sun is in the 10th house, but for the Capricorn ascendant, because Surya is debilitated, then these people have to work relatively more harder to gain that position, that post, that level of name, fame, recognition, and also to maintain that becomes very difficult, especially if some other planets like Saturn is aspecting the Sun. Then you can always have some level of challenges from your subordinates, or some self-doubt within yourself that, oh, can I do this? Can I maintain this? Yes. So these are the issues which can come up if Sun is in directional strength, but it is in a difficult sign. All right. But because it is in directional strength, this person will be sitting in some kind of a leadership position, some kind of a leadership role. It may not be very big, like they may not become the prime minister of a country or a president of a nation. But even within their circles, they will be a very good leader. Now, people will go to them and ask for advice. They will go and ask them, oh sir, please tell me what I can do regarding this, what I can do regarding that. Yes. And Sun also shows commitment and sticking to your principle. So these people are very strong. So anytime you want to select employees, then please select those people who have either Sun or Mars in the 10th house, because these people are very dedicated, hardworking people. Because when there are Agni Tattva planets in the Karma Bhava, which is the 10th house, then they are very much focused towards work. So these people, I have seen, they can work for very long hours, yes, consistently, without feeling that, oh, I can't work, I want to work only for 4 hours. So those problems do not come when fiery planets are there in the 10th house. But on the other side, I have seen people who have watery planets like Moon or Venus associated with the 10th house, which means if they are sitting there or if they are lording the 10th house, then I have seen these people come and tell me, oh sir, I can't work, please tell me, you know, will I have to work like this for lifetime, for 18 hours, for 16 hours? But if somebody has Sun and Mars, then that's it, bang on. You tell them that you have to work for 10 hours, they'll be like, yes, I'll do it. Any task you give them, they will finish it and ultimately submit the results to you, so that you will be like, yes, this person has done the work properly. It may not be necessarily very efficient, but they will complete the task, they will finish it till the end. All right, so that's what is the 10th house. 10th house is the house of professionalism. 10th house is where you show to the world who you are. So when fiery planets are there, then this person is very determined to show themselves that, yeah, to show to others that, yes, I am somebody, look to me, I am like the Sun. Yes, because at 12 o'clock in the noon time, when Sun is in the 10th house, everybody sees the Sun. Sun is visible everywhere. Yes, it's so hot that time. So when somebody has Surya Mangal in the 10th house, then it also becomes like they are all over the place like when Sun is in the afternoon time. All right, so that is what I wanted to say regarding the Digbala of fiery planets. So this new series is starting, and we will continue with the Digbala of other planets. All right, so that is it from my side. If you have any questions, queries or comments, then let me know. Or what else do you want me to make, and what do you think of this video or some other videos which I have made in my channel. And if you're new, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then approach me through my website below, and wait for the Digbala videos of other planets: Jupiter, Mercury, Moon, Venus and Saturn. Okay, then until next time with the Digbala of other planets, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.